Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel, and in this video we are going to understand useRef in a dev. So we will see different use cases or useRefs. So overall we will see five different set of use cases. Okay, so before moving forward, please subscribe this channel to get more video on React. So before jumping into the example, so let's get a little bit insight about useRef. So basically useRef is used in React to basically access the DOM element. Okay, so you can access the DOM element with its current property. Okay, so with the help of current property you can access the DOM, and it return an object which basically persists for the whole time of a component, for whole lifetime of the component. That means the component will never basically re-render. If you change any value, if you change reference value, so it never re-render the component. So as you can see that you can basically focus the input while initial render. So and it's also stated here like useRef does not notify when its content change. So mutating the current property does not cause a re-render. Okay, so with the help of current property we can basically change the value, but that does not cause a re-render. So that is the difference between useRef and the useState. useState basically trigger the re-render whenever state change. Okay, so these are the five use case we will see in this video. Okay, so first use case like accessing the DOM element. So as you can see, once the page load, we are able to focus on the input element. So that can be achieved with the help of useRef. And the second is like reference to store number. So whenever you click, so it will basically store the number. So it will basically update the click count basically whenever you click. And the third one is like you can also store the previous value. So suppose if you are adding, so if current count is 0 and we don't have a previous count because current count is 0, so if you add, so the current count will get updated and the previous count will be a 0. So like that you can basically store the previous value with the help of useRef. And another use case, like you can also control the style with the help of useRef. So if you click on this button, so you can see the size of input box get changed. So that you can also control with the help of useRef. And the last one is like we will be building a stopwatch. So here you can start the timer and you can stop and you can reset. So this thing also we will be achieving with the help of useRef. Okay, so let's jump into the VS Code to start a use case, basically to start implementing use case one by one. Okay, So as you can see, I have just removed all the content inside this class name app, and I have pasted like 5 use case, and we will be putting each use case one by one. Okay, so let's create one folder like component. So component. And inside the component, we will create the first use case. Okay, so use case one, like so the use case one, ref we need, and we need use effect. Define and you might know this use case from other video, I guess. So you have to use the use effect, because on first render we will be basically focusing the that and first we will see the console log here. So in so you can access that property using the current. Okay, so let's see. Okay, we have to import. Okay, so here and I think this will be the longest video, will be on use ref only. So just stay with this video, so you will get whole idea about how use ref work in React. So let's see. Okay, so you can see we are able to access this DOM with the help of this current property. Okay, now you can basically do whatever you want. So we'll be basically focused once the page load. Okay, you can see our focus is coming after the first render. Since we are using the use effect and we haven't provided any dependencies, so this use effect will run during the first render. Okay, so this is the use case first, where we access the DOM element and we were able to focus the input. And if you try to console log like input ref current like this, so you will get undefined, because during initial render it will log undefined. Okay, so you won't able to access this element. Now come to the second use case. So I will just copy to save some time. We need test value 0, okay, and basically shift. So how you can get the value, so you can access the value using counter.current only. And just get rid of this console. And change the export name and import here. So VS Code automatically import. Here you can see. So every time it will show you the value get incremented by one after each click. So this is the another use case of useRef. Now let's see the third use case of useRef. I will rename this one and I think this will be a little bit different from other, so I will just copy the first one and paste here. So in this you need use state as well. Okay, so count set count use state. So we will initialize the counter value with 0. Change this one. Enter count. So you can increment this way. Okay, so this is the proper way to increment the count. and I will have line break here and span to show you the current count. And we will have another line break to show you the previous count value. So we need to define here in use effect the previous count. You can store like this count, and you can watch this count whenever count value get updated. So this use effect basically update the basically it's track of the previous count value. So this use effect will run every time when the count is changed. So we can access the previous count value using previous count dot current. And then we need to bring it here. Okay, so use case, I think we haven't changed the export here. Okay, so bring it in. Okay, here. Okay, some typo, I think. Okay. So you can see we are able to store the previous count with the help of useRef. So this is another use case we have seen using the useRef hook. And let's see the fourth use case where we can control the styling also with the help of useRef. Okay, so let's copy this one. I will name it 4. Okay, so almost everything will be the same. We need to remove this use effect. We don't need this use effect. We can get rid of this console. And we only require useRef for this. So we need button as well. And we need button here. So on click, I am giving the name change size. Okay, so now we need to specify the style. So we can do a inline styling here. So issue width, I am giving 100 pixels, and now inside the handler count size is the style. So current dot style dot width is equal to, not double equal, only single equal. Now let's import this one. So after clicking change file, you can see the size of input box get changed. Okay, so with the help of user, we can also control the styling in React. So this is the another use case we have seen. Now let's move on to the last use case where we will be building a stopwatch with the help of user. So let's create the last file, use case 5, and I will be writing from the scratch here. So import React. So we need only at user, we need use ref effect required. So on use case 5, so default use case 5, okay. So to build this stopwatch, we need to store the timer reference. Okay, so we need to store the timer reference here. So use ref. Let's first write all three buttons here first. So start, and we will give the name start timer. I will copy two more times. It will be and we will just create this handler. Okay, so just create this one so we don't get any error. Reset timer. Okay, so just import here. Okay, so let's see. So now we are able to see our button. Okay, so and let's also. the logic in the respective handler. First, we will start with the start time. If nothing, and we will set the timer thing. So increase using the head interval built-in JavaScript method. And we will increase the count. So it will increase by 1 second. So every 1 second increase by 1 second. So you can see here we are able to start the timer. Now we have to write the logic to stop the timer. So to stop the timer, we can write clear interval. This is another built-in JavaScript method to stop the timer. So basically clear the interval which is set by the set interval method. Just need to park the time ref dot current. Timer. And we are able to stop the timer as well. Now another is we need to reset the timer. So to reset the timer, we have to write the logic, same logic again. Here only additional thing we have to write here to basically set the count value to 0 basically, and we have to add the use effect as well here. So this use effect basically work as a component will and mount. So we are basically writing a cleanup function here. So this is the cleanup function basically with the help of use effect. So it will do the same job whatever it's doing here. Okay, so let's see. So we are able to start the timer, we are able to stop the timer, and we are able to reset the timer as well. So we have saw a hype use case related to the use ref hook in React, and I hope you understand use ref concept very well. And this is just not limited to hype use case. There can be more number of cases where we can use the use ref inside our React component. So I hope you enjoy this video, and if you enjoy this video, then please subscribe this channel and like the video as well. Thank you so much for watching this video. Bye bye.